This is JEO-PARODY.
Please welcome today's contestants. A penguin from Antarctica, Happy McFeet. A snake from the Amazon rainforest, Monty Python. And a snowman from your own backyard, Jordan Freezer. And now, you know him, you love him, I guess, Mason Mags.
Happy holidays, everybody. My name is Mason Mags, and welcome to another exciting episode of JEO-PARODY. Today we have a very Wait, why is it snowing? We're indoors. It shouldn't be snowing. In fact, it's very chilly in here already. Hey, editing guy, whoever's in the editing booth there, can you, like, edit this out? Or, yeah, there we are. Okay, thank you.
Hey, but I need snow to live.
Don't worry, Jordan. We'll edit that effect back in for the scenes you're in.
Oh, really? Well, thank you, Mason.
Of course. Now, as I was saying, we have a very special episode planned for today, both for our contestants and for our viewers. For all our contestants, we have prepared gift bags.
Is it fish? I love fish!
No, actually, I wouldn't get too excited over the gift bags. They just have one item. The one thing you can get anybody for the holiday season. A candle!
That's right, kids. Get your parents the gift that they don't want this holiday season, but are gonna get anyway. Candles, for when you really don't know the person well.
And for our viewers at home, we have a very special episode planned, so how about we get right into it? Let's get started then. First things first, we want all of our viewers to have a Merry Xmas. Notice the X in quotation marks. Each correct response contains that letter. And a Happy New Year. Next, holiday treats. Yummy. Then we're gonna let it snow. And finally, when one bulb goes out. You hear that a lot during the holidays. Jordan, please start us off.
Let's start with holiday treats for 200.
Even though they're available year-round, the marshmallow chicks and bunnies from this company are especially popular at Easter.
Monty.
What are peeps?
That's it.
Okay, how about we go for Merry Xmas for 400?
Okay, you might say this word to a person who just broke a mirror. You might also say it if you and that same person say something at the exact same time.
Happy.
What is a jinx?
That's correct.
Jinx! Now you owe me an eggnog.
Well played, Happy. I'll get you your eggnog.
Okay, how about we go for Happy New Year for 800?
Answer, the Daily Trouble. Now then, how much would you like to wager?
I'd like to wager $1,000.
Okay, here's the clue.
1908 was the year that this New Year's tradition started. More than 100 years later, thousands of people still visit New York to watch it.
What is watching the crystal spheroid drop?
That is correct.
Yay, I got it right. Okay, I think we'll go for Let It Snow for 400.
In 2008, the people of Bethel, Maine, built a 122-foot-tall one of these, the largest one ever built. It was complete with a chicken wire nose and a mouth made out of tires.
Jordan.
What is an asexual snow person?
Yes, although technically it was a snow woman.
Oh, okay then. Well, how about we go for holiday treats for 600?
All right. Popular around Thanksgiving, this dessert is said to represent the Last Supper because it's made with 13 ingredients, including raisins, breadcrumbs, and brandy.
Monty.
What is figgy pudding?
Right.
Happy, did you just give Monty the answer?
Well, yes. Yes, I did. I was just sharing the good wealth. It is Christmas. It's a time for giving.
Wow. That is beautiful. That is something real special right there. Well, your turn to pick.
Well, thank you, Happy. Okay, I think we're gonna go for holiday treats for 800.
A Christmas tale tells of this type of cookie that comes to life and encourages people to run, run as fast as you can.
Jordan.
What is a gingerbread nut? Oh, wait, sorry. What is an asexual gingerbread person?
I guess we'll accept that.
Okay, then. Let's go for Merry Xmas for 1,000.
As a noun, it might refer to the fumes that come out of a car. As a verb, it might refer to a car running out of gas. Nope, nothing. Well, the answer we were looking for was exhaust. Just like how I'm exhausted of this snow texture. Thank you. Now, would you please pick again?
I'll take Happy New Year for 600.
According to a survey, the most popular New Year's resolution is not to lose weight. Instead, people want to do this similar activity more.
Happy.
What is to exercise more?
Correct.
Monty, you just gave Happy the answer.
Well, I was just returning the favor.
Trying my best to hold back the tears. Happy, please pick again.
Merry Xmas for 200, please.
Dating back to the 9th century, this percussion instrument requires you to whack the wooden bars with a mallet.
Jordan.
What is an asexual xylo person?
We won't accept that. Monty.
What is a xylophone?
That's it.
Okay, I think I'll go for when one bulb goes out for 200.
They all do this.
Monty.
What is they all go out?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Okay, let's go for let it snow for 800.
Aomori City is nicknamed the snowiest city in the world, receiving about 26 feet of snowfall a year. Aomori City is located in this country, the snowiest country in the world.
Jordan.
What is Japan?
Right.
Okay. You know, I have a lot of family up in Japan. I have a little brother who lives in Aomori City. I also have a great big sister who lives in Bethel, Maine. I also have an uncle who lives somewhere in Russia. I also have an aunt who lives in...
Oh, does anyone else hear bells? Oh, you all know what that means. Sure doesn't. It means it's time for our final round. Let's take a look at the category for today. The history of Christmas. Very interesting. Contestants, please make your wagers. We'll be right back with the clue. We would like to take a moment to thank our sponsor, Candy Canes. They're just peppermints, but harder to unwrap. Welcome back to Jet Parody, folks. We're in our final round today. The category... That's better. Our final category for today is the history of Christmas. Contestants, here's the clue. This Roman god celebration, filled with partying and gambling, used to be celebrated from December 17th to 23rd. In the 4th century, Christian churches replaced this holiday with Christmas. 30 seconds, players, good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, let's see what you all wrote down for our final question today. Happy, we come to you first. What did you write down? What is Saturnalia? That is correct. Great job, Happy. And what will you add? That eggnog I was promised. You'll get your eggnog. Monty, you're up next. What did you write down? What is Saturnalia? The correct response. And you will get figgy pudding because now I want some. I'll get you figgy pudding too. And finally, Jordan, what did you write down? The correct response. And we will get one present for Mason?
Yes, a gift for you, Mason. Me and all the contestants pulled together and we got you a small gift for the holidays. I really hope you like it.
Oh, wow. Really? For me? Oh, well, thank you, guys. You shouldn't have. I wasn't expecting a gift. Wonder what it could be. Let's open it up. Wow! It's a candle! Wow, you guys know me not at all.
Well, you know what? Christmas isn't about gifts, or trees, or tinsel, or any of that. It's about all the fun we'll have lighting candles.
Aw, you know what? You guys are right. I think this calls for a group picture. Everybody in.
Oh, yeah. Photo.
Get in there. You go right here.
I don't know.
Okay. There on there. Okay. You guys get in my hands. All right. Now say cheese.
Cheese.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells time and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air. What a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time to go gliding in the one horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the jingle bell.